At this point, I would like to walk you through just a very brief plate tectonic reconstruction, really spearheaded by one guy putting together a whole lot of different geological evidence. And this animation will show the position of the continents over approximately the past 600 million years and how they've changed in response to tectonic forces. If we're careful, we can follow exactly what Tennessee or any part of the world has looked like over time, figuring out how they've moved and how the climate has changed in the area. So let's start that. When I say plate tectonic reconstruction, I mean a reconstruction based on the geologic evidence going back in time. So we really need to be able to read this rock record to figure all this out, because we're looking for evidence like rocks that formed on the land surface versus in oceans, evidence of things like past metamorphism or plate tectonic collisions, right? We saw how many folded mountain belts were created by convergence. Things like fossils and the way that those match up. We can use all of these to correlate rocks from one side of the Earth to another and say that these rocks were once connected to one another, because they formed at the same time in approximately the same place at the time. So that's what a plate tectonic reconstruction ends up being. Here's a map as we think Earth looked 600 million years ago. Thought question, why do you think they colored the land brown here? Why isn't it green? That's because land plants didn't actually exist until 400 or so million years ago. So none of this looks very familiar to us right now. It looks like everything was combined into one supercontinent. We had a big ice sheet, but for the most part, Earth is pretty unrecognizable here. Let's see what happens as we step forward in time. You start to see continents separate from one another. And I want to draw your attention to this continent here. That's what I want you to focus on and watch some of its changes, especially the southern coast here. Watch what happens between that and that set of islands to the south. Over this time, 500 to about 450 million years ago, we saw what looked like a convergent boundary. We saw these islands approach this continent and run into one another. Once they collided, we built up a mountain range. As that happened, some of this area in between the two, right? Like think about that, that margin here, this continental margin. So this is a shallow ocean now, but then as the rocks collide into it, it eventually becomes land and then built up into mountains. Over time, those mountains do erode and start to deposit sediment on the inland side. So we've got all this going on all at the same time. We have a second convergence starting here around 430 million years ago, where it looks like these two continents are colliding together, building a relatively large mountain range. And we can see that around 430 million years, we can see the land starting to turn green. This is right around when land plants evolved and started to colonize most of Earth's surface. We have another collision that starts right about 400 million years ago, running into this part. So the original islands that collided were there, and then another terrain that collided there. And then over time, into about 300 million years ago and a little bit later, you get this huge set of mountains that existed. Some of you might look at this and start to just recognize what Earth's surface looks like today based on this configuration. But here's the hint. These mountains right here, they existed at the equator 280 million years ago. These today we would call the Appalachians. Whoa. And this continent right here is called Pangaea. About 300 million years ago, right as the dinosaurs are starting to evolve and come into existence. Those mountains start to erode, and the land further starts to split apart. Splitting. We can see that there are large changes in sea level. Like here, we have intruded some water into the western coast of this continent. This is right around where that original mountain, the original island arc, ran into this continent here. And as we march forward in time, now you should start to recognize it, about 100 million years ago. Marching forward in time, it was true that about 90 million years ago, much of the western US, now we can really see that this looks like North America here. Here's the US, and Florida doesn't even exist yet because it's totally underwater. But a lot of this western US was covered by what we call the Cretaceous Interior Seaway. Doesn't take much time, well, 90 million years, depending on whether you say that's a lot of time or not, to go from what looked like that to pretty similar to what it looks like today. The second to last time step is only 15,000 years ago, and it shows the maximum extent of the ice sheet, the last glacial maximum, extending down into New York, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, to Illinois a little bit, Wisconsin, Minnesota. So that's why there's so much white in the Northern Hemisphere at this point. Here we are in Eastern Tennessee, right about there. And if I march backward in time, take a look at where that point moved and think about all the changes that have happened in Tennessee over the past 600 million years. Okay, so we followed it to here. It was still above sea level about 90 million years ago. Maybe about 200 million years ago, it was on the edge of this former mountain belt as the Atlantic Ocean opens up here. You can still find evidence of this opening up on the coast of the eastern US, because you actually have a lot of flood basalts and muddy sediments that have been laid on the eastern coast of the US. But Tennessee itself at the time was probably more like a desert about 200 million years ago. Now, we don't see a ton of evidence of that remaining today, just because so much of it is eroded away. Let's continue further back in time. Tennessee's probably somewhere like that. And the very core of this ancient Appalachian mountain chain remains as the Blue Ridge Mountains, as Great Smoky Mountains. So all of that used to be buried under miles and miles more rock that has since eroded away. Marching back in time just a little bit more. Somewhere like here is Tennessee. Some of it was probably underwater at this point. And it was very close to the tropics. It's probably a very warm ocean. Continuing on, about 430 million years ago, Tennessee was probably all underwater. And because this is still one of these warm oceans, most of what was precipitated in Tennessee at the time was coral reef sediments. Once coral reefs lithify, they're limestone. That's the state rock of Tennessee because we have so much of it. Because a whole lot of rock in Tennessee formed around this time was laid down, was probably later buried, but then most of that sediment that it was buried by has eroded away, like those desert sediments that we saw before. Following it all the way 600 million years ago, somewhere over here. And at some point, we may have even been in the Arctic, Antarctic anyway. Marching forward in time, watching how Tennessee changes over time. You can see that Tennessee has experienced a whole lot of climate changes and geological changes purely based on the motion of these plates over time. So that's the end of this lecture. Thanks for listening. I hope you got something out of it, and we'll see you next time.